I think I've learned a lot from my brothers and sisters in Latin America particularly, who come up with this concept of praxis. You know, and you say, wow, that's a heavy word. Praxis, P-R-A-X-I-S, what in the world's practice? Praxis, it's this. It's if you don't have faith that the world's going to be a better place, this is going to sound fine, then involve yourself in activities that will make it a better place. Your involvement in those kinds of activities will change the way you think. So often, coming as we do from the Greek philosophies, we think that first you get people's head straight. You know, if we get their thinking straight and their heart right, then their actions will flow from that. So if we get you thinking positively, and if we get you feeling positively, you will act positively. And, you know, Robert Schuller, Norman Vincent Peale have made a strong practice of this. And I think they're right, but only half right. The other half is this, and I think they would agree with me, that if you don't have that in your head or in your heart, but you become involved in doing things that change the world in a more positive way and make the world into a more positive place, that bring justice where there is none, even if it's in a small way, that Habitat for Humanity, you know, we build a house for somebody that's poor. You do those kinds of things, and those actions create faith. In short, I would argue that what we do to further justice and have justice for the poor and the oppressed, what we do to improve life for those who have been beaten down, makes us into people of faith as much as it is something that flows out of our faith.